Hello, my dear students. I think you all are safe at your home. Don't forget to wear mask when you go outside. Avoid touching your eyes, nose, and mouth frequently. Now, I am here to teach you abstract nouns. Abstract nouns. Then, in lower classes, you have learned nouns. Before moving into abstract nouns, let's see what's a noun. A noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, feelings, or an idea. Noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, feelings, or an idea. Then in lower classes you have learned common noun and proper noun. What do you mean by a common noun? General name. Common name means general name. Proper noun means specific name. Common noun, general name, proper noun, specific name. Specific name. Let's see this example. Remember, common noun, general name, proper noun, specific name. First one is Vidyalaya. This is common. It may be any Vidyalaya. Next one, Chinmaya Vidyalaya. Our school. Next one, country, India. Country is common, India is proper. Next one, language. This one is common, English. This one is proper. Next one, day. Common, Friday, proper. Month, common, June, proper. That means, common noun means general name, proper noun means specific name. But in this chapter, you should remember one important point. When you write days of the week or months of the year, it may be June, July, August, September, whatever it may be, you should begin with capital letter. Begin with capital letter. Monday, M must be capital. Tuesday, T must be capital. When you write June, J must be capital. When you write December, D must be capital. That you should remember. Now move on to abstract noun. Now abstract nouns. Abstract nouns have no physical existence. Abstract nouns have no physical existence. Second one, we cannot touch them. Then what are the points you should remember when we talk about abstract nouns? Abstract nouns have no physical existence. We cannot touch them. Abstract nouns have no physical existence. We cannot touch them. For example, this is a marker. It has physical existence, so I can touch it. Noun means, noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, feeling, or an idea. This is a marker. I can touch it. That means it has physical existence. As in the case of abstract noun, it has no physical existence. Second point is, we cannot touch them. Now move on to the examples. First one, happiness. It has no physical existence. We cannot touch it. Next one, life. Satisfaction. Goal. Now, let's see these examples. We have to get the truth of the matter. We have to get the truth of this matter. That means truth. Then which is the abstract noun in this sentence? Truth is the abstract noun in this sentence. Next one, don't underestimate your own strength. Then which is the abstract noun in this sentence? Strength. That means abstract nouns have no physical existence. We cannot touch them. Okay, all of you understand? Listen, abstract nouns have no physical existence. We cannot touch them. Then what are the points you should remember about nouns? Noun means, noun is the name of a person, place, animal, thing, feelings, or an idea. Common noun means general name. Proper noun means specific name. Then abstract noun means, abstract noun has no physical existence. We cannot touched. These are the points you should remember before doing the exercise from your grammar test. Now, we must do the exercise from your grammar test. All of you take your grammar test.
Listen, all of you. Underline the nouns in these sentences. Write their kinds. King Solomon was famous for his wisdom. King Solomon, proper noun, wisdom, abstract noun. Second one, platinum is a precious metal. Platinum, proper noun, metal, common noun. Third one, the earth moves around the sun. Earth, proper noun, sun, proper noun. Nashik is situated on the banks of the river Godavari. Nashik, proper noun, river, common noun, Godavari, proper noun. Sushmita is a bright student. Sushmita, proper noun, student, common noun. Now move on to the next exercise. Exercise B. Underline the abstract nouns in these sentences. There could be more than one abstract noun in some sentences. To my delight, all my friends came to my birthday party. Which is the abstract noun in this sentence? Delight. Second one, my father is known for his honesty. Which is the abstract noun in this sentence? Honesty. Shaira has high hopes of winning a medal at tomorrow's sports event. Hopes, abstract noun, event, abstract noun. Cruelty to animals is a punishable offense. Cruelty, abstract noun, offense, abstract noun. Childhood is the best part of one's life. Childhood, abstract noun, life, abstract noun. Asif showed great determination and courage in the face of danger. Determination, abstract noun, courage, abstract noun, and danger, abstract noun. Now, move on to the next exercise. Make abstract nouns from these common nouns, adjectives and verbs. Delightful, delight. Woman, womanhood. Heal, healing. Know, knowledge. Cheerful, cheerfulness. Brilliant, brilliance. Ambitious, ambition. King, kingdom. Generous, generosity. Frighten, fright. Next exercise. Fill in the blanks by using the correct forms of the words given in brackets. Dash is always appreciated. In bracket, it is given punctual. What is the answer? Punctuality is always appreciated. Next one, Deepa does her work with dash and dash. In bracket, sincere and dedicate. What is the answer? Deepa does her work with sincerity and dedication. Next one, we should eliminate dash from the society, the politician said. Bracket, it is given corrupt. What is the answer? Corruption. We should eliminate corruption from the society, the politician said. Next one, India gained dash from the British on 15th August 1947. Bracket, it is given free. The answer is, India gained freedom from the British on 15th August 1947. Next one, on Republic Day, soldiers are awarded medals for dash. In bracket, it is given brave. The answer is, on Republic Day, soldiers are awarded medals for bravery.
All of you complete your grammar test today itself. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Thank you all.